Let's start by answering a basic question to introduce JavaScript. What is JavaScript? At its core, JavaScript, as a small, lightweight, object-oriented scripting language, connects to objects of host environments and provides programmatic control over them. Now, that host environment is most commonly a web browser. We call this client-side JavaScript. With JavaScript, we access the document object model in order to handle mouse movements of the user, button clicks, information and input fields, and more. Now, JavaScript can extend to a variety of utilities. For example, there is also the concept of server-side JavaScript that uses a language to run servers and communicate to databases. Now, let's clear up a very common question. What is the difference between JavaScript and Java? Well, for one, they're two completely different languages. Now, we can get down to the nitty-gritty and unpack the computer science differences. For example, Java compiles on a system of classes, while JavaScript supports a system based on small data types representing numerics, strings, and true and false values. But the main point is that JavaScript is a much more free-form language when compared to Java. Unlike Java, in JavaScript, you don't need to keep track of whether variables are public, private, protected, etc. These minimal requirements for JavaScript make the language so small and lightweight, and can also ease our experience coding in the language. Next, what is ECMAScript? Why do we sometimes refer to JS as ES6? The reason JavaScript is also called ECMAScript is that ECMA International in Europe standardizes the language and also happens to call the language ECMAScript. So whenever they release an official version of the language, we can refer to that version as ES or ECMAScript and 6 and the version number. All right, great. This leads to the all-important question for any programmer. What do I need to know to start working with JavaScript? Luckily, JavaScript is very easy to learn, even if you haven't programmed before. If you made it this far, you definitely know how the internet works, so some of you might already know about HTML. HTML is the markup language in the background of every page that you visit that defines its structure. Now, once you look at HTML, you'll find that it's actually very intuitive. In the next video, we'll briefly review HTML and the main concepts, and highlight the few things you'll need to know about this markup language in order to program in JavaScript. And then right after, we'll start interacting with JS and getting right to the code.